r/askreddit by Reddit and chill. What is the most terrifying creature on earth? Pork tapeworms. Which can cause neurocysticercosis. Just fills your brain with holes. Hey. I have this. Emma. Fishers. The weasel-looking animal, but they're ducking psychopaths. I'm from a rural part of Pennsylvania and the hunters are like duck bears. A fisher will rip your face off. So yeah. Pretty terrifying. Plus they sound like someone screaming, which is the worst thing to hear in the middle of the night. One of the most violent and often unpredictable creatures on this planet is the hippopotamus. It can see you from a distance and say, "Duck you. I want you dead." They are more dangerous than large cats and bears due to being even more hyper-territorial. They kill 500 plus people every year in Africa. When I went to Tanzania, the only time I saw our guides extremely apprehensive was around hippos. I asked one why and he said they are the mean a-holes from deepest hell. To me. Ticks. Cannot ducking stand a thought of them. My sister-in-law was bitten by a Lone Star tick and now she can't eat red meat for the rest of her life. Komodo dragon. The idea of something poisoning me and then following me around until I die. Just so it can eat me is terrifying. And their mouths are absolutely disgusting. All the bacteria and diseases carried in that thing makes my skin crawl. Just like humans. Ophiocordyceps. It's a fungus. So not really a creature. But it's horrifying. Headline from the story below. After this fungus turns and into zombies. Their bodies explode. Nighttimes.com link. Video of infected insects. Yautabi link. The book and movie adaptation, The Girl with All the Gifts, was based on it. It was also the source of The Infection and The Last of Us. The platypus. Its stings just hurt you forever to the point that most people ask for the limb to be removed so the pain stops. But they also save the world from mad scientists. A fair trade. You can get leprosy from touching an armadillo. That's kinda crazy. But we wouldn't know most of what we do about leprosy if we hadn't found a model animal that contracts if. They've saved more lives than they've ruined. Unless one of the many cryptids out there gets found out to be real. I am going to go with kandaroo. Those things terrify me. The dreaded kandaroo. Crocodile. They have not changed in the last 200 million years because they are the perfect predator. Saltwater crocodiles are easily the scariest animal in Australia as far as I'm concerned. There are plenty of highly venomous animals. But our hospitals are generally equipped to deal with a lot of those. Plus, the snakes and spiders are mostly shy, elusive creatures, Sydney funnel webs notwithstanding. The ones which don't run away are just mindless jellyfish or maybe stonefish hoping you'll go away. Crocodiles don't run. They're one of the few species which actively hunt humans as prey. Venom would be an awful way to die. But it seems less horrific than being ripped apart by a one-ton reptile. Praying mantis. No venom. No poison. Just patience and trickery. Beautiful silent killers of the insect world. Practically invisible to their victims. So effective they make prey out of mammals, birds, and even snakes. Anything that's found in the deep sea. Here is some nightmare fuel for you tonight. Angry male chimp or humbled squid. Yikes. Jamie. Bring that shit up. Can't decide between a sperm whale, a great white shark, and a bluefin tuna. A sperm whale can kill you by accident just by speaking to you or around you. No joke. Their clicks are so loud the sound waves literally destroy the tissue inside your body and worse. It's super dangerous and risky to study them because of this, and they like to talk to us and each other as they are curious. Though some can be mean and deadly, others can be quite sweet. So it's unfortunate. Great white shark, because they attack so fast it takes those special crash test cameras just to capture their attack. Chances are if you see a great white shark just ambling around in the ocean, it doesn't want to eat you. Because you would have been dead in less than a second if it wanted to. So there's some peace in mind for that. However, you don't want to stick around for it to change its mind either. Quietly make sandwich. There are these trees in Australia that have little spikes on them. Even if you just brush up accidentally of one of them, Spikes with spike you. It hurts like a beach. The pain never goes away. Hair never grows back in the area where it was stung. You can't see the spikes. They're microscopic. They look like any regular tree. They terrify me. Basically, some trees are evil. The Jimpy Jimpy? They're only in rainforests. Like, objectively speaking or just from our human perspective? Objectively. Yeah, that's us. For us. Parasites. Because they literally kill you from the inside and they use you to make more horrible little parasitic monsters. Like a plague. They literally kill you from the inside and they use you to make more horrible little parasitic monsters. Like a plague. Boy, wait until you hear about viruses. They do this and then transfer their spores by means of anything from coughing and sneezing to making you use contaminated bodily fluids. At least the parasites have limited ways of transfer. We are marathon hunters. What other animal hunts you relentlessly until you escape? Just to track you down to your resting place and continue to hunt you. A dedicated and skilled human can hunt and track its prey for days to weeks. We took a natural predator, wolves. Decided to capture and systematically breed them to the point where they serve us as loyal companions. Also, to every other animal on the planet, we must appear freakish and terrifying. No fur. We walk on two legs. Even though our front appendages are long enough to use as feet. And we cover ourselves in layers of material, often the flesh of other animals, to keep our furless bodies warm. Edit. I woke up to this shiny thing in my coffee. Thank you for my first gold, kind stranger. The old story I love about the deer and the first humans. Imagine you're a deer and you see this thing come running at you with a spear. You escape easily and an hour later. You see this thing again. Still running. You escape again. This time running out of the forest into some grasslands. You turn back to see the creature exiting the woods. Still coming at you. You decide to finally run through the hills. Exhausted as you come to rest on a hilltop. As you stand there. Breathing heavily. You see the creature crest the hill. Still running. Octopus. They're so ducking smart. It's terrifying. Wait till you hear about humans. Wasps though. Hate those bastards. Fun fact. Pick any random insect species. And there's a pretty good chance that there's a species of parasitic wasp that has evolved to lay its eggs only in that insect. There are even parasitic wasps that lay their eggs in other parasitic wasps. I was in Kenya and I met an old Maasai man who was telling me the dangers of lions and elephants. I asked, "What animal should we be most afraid of?" He replied, "Not elephants. Not lions. The animal to fear most is the Kenyan police. Got shook down 3 times at gunpoint for money, you pay fine in cash now. By corrupt cops in 3 weeks. Duckin' scary. They do stalk around like hungry jackals. But jackals with AKs. As a Kenyan, I can tell you for a fact that they are the most feared people here. They would rather watch you die in the hands of a mob than save you and have to fill the paperwork and give testimonies in court. I'm gonna say something unpopular. But bar none, the scariest thing is a cockroach. I mean, think about it. They can fit in tiny places and it's just suddenly poof. They are gone just like that. Have you ever had a cockroach fly at your head? I swear it's the worst shit. And they just won't duck and die. You can step on them all you want but they just won't duck and die. Put it in a blender. Ducker isn't coming back to life after that one. Moose or hippo? Definitely the hippopotamus. The Alaskan bullworm. Imo. Grizzly bears. Especially the big ones. I regret watching The Revenant. You should watch the movie The Edge with Anthony Hopkins and Alec Baldwin. Who the hell is this man giving out awards? K-I-N-D. S-T-R-A-N-G-E-R. The Komodo dragon. It was believed their bite was so deadly because of the shit ton of funky bacteria in their mouths. This has been proved wrong with swabs of the dragon's mouths followed by analysis of the product of the swabs. Their mouths aren't any more or less nasty than any other animal's. Their bite is almost always fatal because they are venomous. The venom contains some toxic proteins that cause rapid blood loss, inhibition of clotting, paralysis, and extreme pain. The dragon pretty much hangs around the victim and waits for it to lose consciousness because of pain or become paralyzed. Then moves in to kill it and enjoy a succulent meal with a side of fava beans. Popsy.com link. Humans. Followed by those amoeba things which go up your nose and eat your brain. Followed by those amoeba things which go up your nose and eat your brain. My brother's wife is a microbiologist. And she put up a pretty solid defense for those little critters. I don't have the creds to repeat them in detail though. I think the basic gist is that they don't go after brains in the wild. But they can't tell the difference between our brains and what they eat in the wild. Chihuahuas. They contain the most evil energy of any creature in all of known existence. 33% evil. 33% hate. 34% tremble. My ex, when she starts replying okay, it's fine. Blue ringed octopus. Found in what's left of the Great Barrier Reef. Its tentacles contain a venom that can kill an adult man in about 15 minutes. The tetrodotoxin is in their saliva, which is delivered when they bite with their beak, which they only do when threatened and handled. 15 minutes is not a likely time frame. TTX is also found in puffer fish and several salamander species in the Pacific Northwest. Source: I'm a PhD candidate studying venoms. Anything that kills prey slowly and painfully. Bonus points if doing so involves attacking the brain. Honey badger. Honey badger. Honey badger. Honey badger. My dad grew up in Louisiana and he said he was more afraid of badgers than any gators. A badger will chase you down to kick your ass. A badger will climb a tree to kick your ass. Never duck with a badger. The brown recluse spider. It bites you and literally makes you skin rot off. And it ducking tiny. That is not completely accurate. The necrotization of a brown recluse spider bite is actually the result of a bacteria that the spider might carry and not the bite itself. My mom. She remembers every single thing you've ever done. Tells them in a way that makes her the poor victim and you the heartless culprit. And spends 2 hours doing this whenever you disagree with her on anything. And don't you even dare interrupting her, you ungrateful a-hole. Who boy are you in for a treat? In my opinion, the lamprey are an ancient extant lineage of jawless fish of the order Petromyzontiformes. Placed in the superclass Cyclostomata. The adult lamprey may be characterized by a toothed, funnel-like sucking mouth. Totally didn't Google it. Y-O-O-O, I actually have something that isn't depression. Upvotes. I find cephalopods to be terrifying yet tasty. Those giant octopi. You can't change my mind. What about that thing in the Amazon that swims up your pee hole? Ducking, like, and subscribe.